What separates a high-performance wealth management team or a high-performance financial practice from all the rest? The business development is the critical aspect of an ongoing successful 21st century financial practice. What they're looking for is a solutions provider, somebody to solve problems in the multidimensional aspects of their financial affair and provide high-level service. Don't we love calling that 800 number and talking to somebody in Sri Lanka about your cell phone bill? How do you get paid? What are your fees? We want to know. There's no way I can answer that question at this juncture. I mean, we work with a select group of families here in the area like Alan Janders before we could even entertain taking on a new relationship.
Yeah, you're not answering my question. What's your fee?
Business development and client loyalty are your core. You've got to be the real deal. Where financial practices get stagnant is when they stop the growth mode. You're the product and every member of your practice is your brand. So let's say Alexander is one of my top 25 clients. Should I know everything there is to know about Alexander? Yes or no? I know what he likes, what he doesn't like. I know what his wife likes, his kids are doing, all that. Two mistakes people make with value propositions. I'm a financial advisor or I'm a financial consultant. What's the translation in the mind of the athlete? Salesperson. The other mistake is they've been value proposition trained and they recite the financial pledge of allegiance. Sales alert antenna goes up. To be a rainmaker for the 21st century financial practice, number one, requires a tremendous amount of energy. Number two, requires unbelievable focus. Number three, requires unbelievable persistence. Think like Tiger. Go out of the comfort zone. Work on aspects of your practice just one step at a time. Persist, 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 and you have no competition. Your future is now. You can take business away from anybody in today's environment. Here's the research on our rainmakers. We researched, you know, financial professionals who were targeting million-dollar plus relationships. We wanted to know who was doing what. What we found out was scathing. Only 7% are bringing in 10 or more new million-dollar plus relationships a year. 7%. I was sharing this with a group of top producers just 2 weeks ago, and somebody said, "That high?" Well, our statisticians looked at this and said, told us, the same statisticians who said a third of those relationships were at risk back in January 2000, they looked at this and said, "This industry's in trouble. They can't do a better job than that." I said, no, the industry's not in trouble. Rainmakers rule. There's no competition for people who can bring in the business. Now, quickly, this is the business development. The mindset of a rainmaker, the mindset of somebody who brings in the business in today's world, according to our data, is somebody who is extraordinarily goal-focused, highly competitive, and they play to win. They hold themselves strictly accountable for bringing in new relationships. They know they have their sales, they're a salesperson, and yet their sales skills are so refined that they're virtually invisible. They're seamless. By the way, rainmakers get rejected more frequently than the typical financial professional. That surprise anybody, by the way? No, because they're out there playing. They have thick skin. They have this mindset of a tiger. Skills of a rainmaker: introductions, referrals, networking. Let me make one bold statement here. Salespeople ask for referrals. Rainmakers penetrate centers of influence by getting personal introductions. Now, let me just do a quick little demonstration. I'm going to use, if you don't mind, Greg and Alexander as an example. We make this way too complicated, by the way. So let's say Alexander is one of my top 25 clients. Should I know everything there is to know about Alexander, yes or no? Absolutely. I know what he likes, what he doesn't like. I know what his wife likes, his kids are doing, all that. He likes me, he trusts me, and I'm his go-to guy. Now, I'm sitting now with Alexander, and I'm upgrading the relationship. I've given him a financial organizer. I've never done this before. And after I finish that, he goes, "Hey, Matt, that's great. You know what? A good colleague of mine, Greg, could really use your services." That's a layup, isn't it? It's a layup referral. I can't tell you the number of financial professionals who blow these layups. How do they blow the layup? I get the number, then I chicken out and don't call Greg. It happens, by the way. Or I get the number, and I start calling Greg. You think he's looking forward to take my phone call? No. Here's one. Or I ask Alexander, "Oh, could you please call Greg and tell him what a good relationship we have and let him know I'll be calling?" So he says, "Yeah." So he calls Greg and warns him I'm going to be calling. Now he knows to avoid my call.